Good evening. Nearly 200 people have needed rescuing from floodwaters after Sydney's monster downpour sent torrents of rain surging across our suburbs. Tonight, power is still out to thousands of residents, while insurers are already putting the damage bill at $45 million. Water restrictions could soon be lifted, with Warragamba now at 60.7%, up nearly 18% in just a week. And we're being told more showers are on the way.
From the chaos to the cleanup, and counting the cost of the huge storm that took Sydney on a wild weather ride, the northern beaches bore the brunt of the damage. Memories of yesterday's terrifying conditions still fresh. As the waters rose, residents near Narrabeen Lagoon had to evacuate.
This is so scary, getting evacuated. My goodness, the lake, it's completely overflowed.
Last night, Narrabeen's coastline was wrapped in a blanket of foam, even covering cars.
Oh my God!
Left today, a mountain of rubble and dirt, and a long, arduous clean-up ahead.
I had to take today off just to go through it.
A little bit scary when the SES sort of knocked on the door. It was, he basically told us to evacuate.
This row of homes at risk after a retaining wall behind them collapsed.
It was insane. We all ran out screaming, and we were like, lucky none of us was out there. And I remember this huge cement block just rolling right up to my window.
We weren't sure how stable the hill is, so we got out.
Trees strewn across roads as the wild weather cut a swathe of destruction.
It was just funneling straight up through the middle, and she's taken everything out on the way.
One toppled onto a fence perilously close to a school. SES dinghies became floating ambulances. As an elderly woman was transported to drier ground, this million-dollar boat at Balmoral left all at sea, the Peter Emma petering on the brink. Its anchor and chain stolen last night when the boat was ransacked by looters.
They've smashed a side window, they've taken the tender, they've taken... It's, what can you say?
As the rain pummeled and waters rose, there were hazards across Sydney. Cars were bogged, needing to be towed. One SES worker at Milperra was bitten by a snake, the rescuer himself needing help and a trip to hospital. The conditions everywhere were trying. The SES rescuing nearly 200 people from floodwaters. At George's Hall, four children and a woman went to hospital, suffering suspected carbon monoxide poisoning. They'd used a generator after losing power. Everywhere, resources were stretched to the limit.
Over the weekend, Fire and Rescue received 16,000 000 calls.
And the SES, 10,500 calls.
Most of the calls have been as a result of fallen trees, damaged roofs and water leaking into homes.
At Picton, the rising waters meant sandbags were brought out and furniture moved up. On a day when records were smashed, Oakdale in the southwest copped 305 millimetres in 24 hours. Linden in the Blue Mountains, 272. Ingleburn, Wentworth Falls and Castle Cove also among the most drenched suburbs.
Torrential rainfall, some really high numbers and some obvious impacts from that.
And plenty of that much-needed rain ended up in Warragamba Dam, although still no word on whether that will mean a change to Level 2 water restrictions.
It's too soon for us to even think about that at this stage.
This once-in-a-generation storm has now been ruled a catastrophe, with insurers receiving more than 10,000 claims worth around $45 million within hours. But like many here in Bayview on the northern beaches, some residents still without communications are yet to contact their insurance companies, so those figures are expected to rise. Today, more than 50 schools impacted by the storms were closed, and around 100,000 homes and businesses remained without power. A huge task for repair crews, contending with downed power lines and trees, damaged wires and flash flooding. A number of suburbs are expected to be declared natural disaster areas tomorrow, allowing for extra funding and support. Among the frightened and exhausted faces, though, some happiness. Those in most of the 1,500 homes evacuated have been allowed back.
He fell.
others taking to the streets, turning a wet and wild weather event...
How we do it in Australia, boys?
..to an excuse for impromptu water sports and outdoor entertainment.
And Natasha Squarey is at Narrabeen for us tonight. Natasha, how is the clean-up going there?
Good evening, Mark. Well, this is ground zero of the storm damage, and after a long day of cleaning up, residents here in Narrabeen are still going. But it might be a little premature just yet, with more bad weather expected here in Sydney later this week. The real concern here around the northern beaches are dozens of homes have been evacuated. They are not allowed to go home tonight. They do not know when they will return to their homes over fears of potential landslips. So, Mark, the effects of this storm and far from over.
Okay, Natasha Squarey at Narrabeen, thank you. A man working on the big clean-up has been critically injured and flown to Liverpool Hospital. Peter Fegan is there. Peter, how was he hurt?
Well, Mark, the 37-year-old is a contractor for an energy company. He was cutting down trees that had fallen onto power lines at Robertson in the Southern Highlands this afternoon when a large branch fell on him, trapping him in the bucket of his cherry picker. His workmates quickly brought him to the ground and a passing RFS crew, along with police, started CPR on him after he went into cardiac arrest. Paramedics then rushed him to a nearby oval before he was flown here to Liverpool Hospital in a critical condition. But, Mark, thankfully, I can report tonight that his condition has improved and he is now currently serious but stable. Mark?
That is some good news. Peter, thank you. The wild weather crippled Sydney's public transport this morning, with flooding and power outages causing chaos for many commuters. Tom Saker is at Central Station. Tom, how's the evening peak coping?
Mark, it will be a very long journey home for many tonight. There are still delays on the Northern Line and problems at Olympic Park. Metro services are still being replaced by buses between Chatswood and Macquarie University. But trains now are up and running once again between Hornsby and Gosford, and also between Campbelltown and Goulburn. But it certainly was a rough day after a night of horrendous conditions. In the Upper Hawkesbury, the school run came with its own hidden pitfalls. The bus flooded, but all students were safe.
What were you thinking going into these floodwaters?
Wasn't thinking.
The floodwaters proved too much for this Aldi truck washed away in McGrath's Hill as the Hawkesbury Nepean rose overnight, swamping this house near Pitt Town. Roads remained cut at North Richmond and Windsor. It was a tough morning commute for train passengers.
Another call in service that just left Cheltenham and will be arriving directly after this train.
Long queues at Macquarie Park after the metro line to Chatswood was cut. Social media awash with images of packed platform. Buses replacing trains on the Central Coastline north of Hornsby, on the Southern Highlands line south of Campbelltown, and on the South Coastline below Wollongong. But the most serious impact remains on the Blue Mountains line after rain washed away the soil underneath the tracks at Lura.
That will take out the Blue Mountains line west of Springwood all the way to Bathurst, probably for a number of days, if not longer than that.
We'd like to know what. How do we get home? They won't even tell us this bus is waiting for us.
So it's taken me about 4 hours instead of 2.5.
This time lapse shows how the tracks flooded at Bardwell Park. Delays too on the Manly Ferry caused by the big swell coming through the heads. Tom Saker, 7 News.
After enduring a devastating flood in 2016, Picton is cleaning up again, another victim of the weekend flooding. Stock had to be piled on the footpath as shopkeepers counted the cost.
So it's just a shop full of mud. So we only had about 6 inches of water, but it was enough to make a significant mess.
Many of the affected stores had undergone major refits following the last big flood. On the bushfire-ravaged south coast, evacuations have now been ordered because of flooding. At Lake Conjola, streets have been swamped only weeks after almost 90 homes burned down. And locals are angry, claiming the flood could have been avoided.
Bushfire wreckage flooded. Lake Conjola enduring one natural disaster as it grieves another.
One extreme to the other, isn't it? I've got no words for it.
I don't believe it.
The rain, bittersweet. Needed, but not like this.
My mum's over there and she's 87. She's crippled. So I'm
don't know how I'm going to get her out of there.
As smoke pours from power boxes and gas tanks float, there's growing anger among the locals. They say this deluge could have been avoided.
Waist deep water through your house is absolutely ridiculous. It could have been stopped.
He's talking about this, opening up the lake to let out the floodwaters. Work the community demanded last year.
They could see this event coming, I think all of New South Wales could see it coming.
And they're not doing what the community wants them to do.
Locals are getting around the best they can.
How's it going?
Good, good.
Trying to keep up their spirits. This shop still open for business.
Open 7 days.
One of the safest ways to get through the main street of Lake Conjola today is by boat. It is difficult to believe that 6 weeks ago this community was blanketed by smoke and overrun by fire. Back then, they were desperate for this kind of rain. It was New Year's Eve. The Currawin fire raged. 89 homes destroyed. The cleanup far from done.
We've all got asbestos. We've got kids. We all want to know what's going to happen there.
As authorities deal with one crisis after another. Miley Hogan, 7 News.
Now to our meteorologist, David Brown. David, it's been called the biggest weather event in a generation.
Yes, indeed, Fergo, and I'm pleased to say, well, it's over. But the past 4 days, of course, delivered the highest rainfall totals in 30 years. And from the Blue Mountains right through to the coast, registrations range from 517.4 millimetres in Katoomba to 205 millimetres in Richmond. Homebush managed 424.6. The city gauge, 391.6. And, of course, it's the largest 4-day total since February 1990. But on radar at the moment, we're just tracking just a few showers and some moderate thunderstorms across the Blue Mountains. In fact, as we go to our future radar, I think we'll see just a few showers and isolated storms returning tomorrow, but mainly during the afternoon and affecting the western half of Sydney. And of course, I'll have local forecasts in detail top of the hour, Fergo.
OK, David, thank you.